My name is Aaron Sumrall. I'm a county extension agent for Texas AgriLife Extension for the part of the A&M University system. Right now, currently in San Jacinto County, and I'm also a PhD candidate at Texas A&M University in College Station. One of the main things that you may have a problem with as far as non-targets is not necessarily a wildlife species, but it's domestic livestock. Domestic livestock sometimes can present quite a headache in a feral pig management removal operation because of the curiosity of the animal, or it may be a stress time of the year where the bait that you're using is something that they can use readily. And one way that we can use that is basically thinking about that, or we can repel that problem, is thinking about that problem before it presents the issue. And that's basically can be alleviated by the shape of the trap, or the size of the trap, dimensions of the trap. And the one that we use the most whenever we're trapping around livestock is this design that we have right here. Basically what it is, it's a cloverleaf lobed front of the trap. And what that does, it creates a funnel into the entry point of a trap. Where if you have a livestock problem, the cameras again are going to tell you what your problem is with non-targets. If you have a livestock problem, know the problem. Is it a calf? Is it a horse? Is it a cow? What's the problem there? And then you can easily address that issue just with the use, making sure that the trap is lobed out the correct way, and use the same line post that you would use to slide those posts in at the height of whatever that non-target species is to repel it. If it's a horse and it's a problem with they maybe making knocking out the trip board or the trip trigger, if it's a horse, you just put the post higher and you can keep those animals out with the spade hooking into the panel. And whenever it comes time to check the trap or to rebait it, they remove easily and they're out of your way. The next thing on non-targets, another thing that what's going to dictate to me whenever I do any trapping is based off that camera and your non-game or non-target species, is the trigger that I'm going to use. The camera is going to tell me what trigger I'm going to use, where in this situation here, if the deer are the primary non-target species that are giving us an issue, a problem, or a handicap on our trapping efforts, is I will hang the bait. And what I mean by hanging the bait is what you do is you set the bait, put your bait in your bucket, set it on any type of wood, firewood block or a cinder block or anything like that. The idea being that the deer, whenever they come in, they're not destructive in their feeding habits typically. So what the idea is that they'll pick up a little bit of your feed, your bait, before they get there. They can pick up a little bit out of your bucket and exit the trap without tripping the string. All while the hogs, in their feeding habits, once they smell that bait in that trap or in that trigger, whenever they knock the bait off the bucket, or knock the bucket off the slant, knock the bait off the post, it will collapse that trigger. You're going to avoid, in this trap situation, this trap trigger set, you're going to avoid some of your problems with deer and almost all of your problems with birds. And the reason for that on birds, whenever they set on your trip string, and the other design will show you, they'll set on your trip string and collapse your board. Whereas this, they can set on this trip string all day long, your trigger string, and it just forces the triggering mechanism even more firm into the gate. But this is the design that we'll use whenever we have deer as the main non-target that we want to avoid. And we'll use the extra line post across the gate whenever livestock is an issue. The next trigger we'll talk about will be whenever we have your smaller mammalian species such as raccoons and opossum is a non-target that we need to avoid. We'll get on that now. This is another design, option and triggering mechanisms that you may want to incorporate. And this one is going to be the used whenever we have your raccoons or your opossum as far as a non-target species that's giving us a problem in our trapping set. So what this basically is just a trip string, and your trip string will go across. First thing you want to do is you want to put your trip string as far to the back of the trap as you can. Now what this trip string will do is this trip string will allow you to set the string above the height of the non-target species, where the raccoons, the opossum, anything like that, and it could even be piglets. Where whenever feral hogs feed, most of the time the piglets, whenever there's a readily available food source, they're going to be the first one to the feed. So whenever the piglets come in, they can stay under while your more trap-shy individuals being on the outside have the time to work their way in. What it is basically is it's a trip string that whenever the legs of the animal collapses the board, it trips the trigger. Now, one thing that would, this is the reason we, obviously, the reason that we do not use this trigger whenever we have deer as a problem is deer will trip the trigger just like the feral hogs will.
So that's why we don't use this. Another issue on this one is this brake board that we have right here. It's just a board that's hinged in the middle, is that whenever birds land on this string, it will collapse that board. So if you have birds as an issue, the other type of triggering mechanism in the front may be what you want to look at. Another issue that we need to think about is on the trip string itself. The cameras, again, are going to tell us what the size of that trip string needs to be. If you have larger sounders of animals, sounders can be up to 30 individuals, maybe more, you want to make sure that you catch as many of those animals as you can, obviously. And what you do is put that trip string further to the back of the trap, and then make sure it's only in a small area where this trip string here is only about 4 foot wide. The reason for that is if the shorter the width of the trip string, if you've got larger sounders, you want as many animals in there before they interact with that trip string as you can. Whereas if you have a solitary boar or you have a small sounder of only a few individuals, you put your trip string across the entire back of the trap going from wall to wall. That way you know that animal or that small sounder is going to interact with that trip string. So small sounders, the trip string needs to be wide. You may not want to even go all the way across the back. Maybe set it a little closer to the front. If the sounders are large, this narrower the trip string. So the cameras, again, will tell you what you need to do on that. But as far as any triggering mechanism, if you have anything that you're confident in that works for you, stay with what works for you, because if you don't have any confidence in it, typically you're not going to use it. So find what works for you. Don't be afraid to change and enjoy trapping hogs.